Good morning students, this is Sheba. Now we are going to discuss about the electronic devices. Unit 1, semiconductor diodes. In our previous session we have discussed about the semiconductors, PN junction diode and its characteristics. Current equation of PN junction diode. Now we are going to discuss about the drift and diffusion current densities of PN junction diode. What is mean by this drift current density? The flow of electric current due to the motion of charge carriers under the influence of external electric field is called drift current. So regarding this PN junction diode, the drift current is calculated for P-type as well as N-type. As you can see in this equation, J drift is equal to Jp for P-type drift value and for plus for N-type drift value. You have to add this two drift values to find the total drift current density. Regarding Jp drift, as we have seen in the previous derivation, its value is equal to Qp mu p into E and its unit is A by centimeter square. Corresponding to the N side, JN drift, same value, only N is changed, QN, mu N, E. So by adding these two values, you will be getting the value of total J drift. That is, I am taking the common terms, J drift is equal to Q into P mu P plus N mu N into E. This Q into P mu P plus N mu N is nothing but sigma conductivity. So J drift is equal to sigma into E. And this is the final value of drift current density. Moving to the another term, diffusion current density. In a semiconductor material, the charge carriers have the tendency to move from the region of higher concentration to that of lower concentration of same type of charge carriers. And this movement results in a current flow which is said to be diffusion current. As you can see in this diagram, which is clearly depicted the movement of charge carriers inside the N-type material. Also, graphical representation of this movement of charge carriers and concentration towards the direction which it has chosen is given in the graph. Talking about the diffusion current density, Jp is equal to minus Q dp into dp by dx, concentration of gradient and diffusion coefficient. Jn Qdn into differentiation dn by dx. So in order to find the total current in P-type semiconductor as well as N-type semiconductor, we need to find the drift as well as diffusion current density. That is, Jp is equal to Jp drift plus Jp diffusion. And Jn is equal to Jn drift plus Jn diffusion. So adding these values gives the total current density inside the semiconductor, both P-type and N-type. Moving to another major category, energy band diagram. We have crossed about this energy band diagram concept a lot while learning physics. What is this energy band diagram and what is energy band means first? First of all, this energy band is nothing but the number of atoms within a crystal can be nearer to each other as well as number of electrons will interact with each other. The energy levels of electrons within their shell can be caused due to the changes in their energy levels. And so this energy band theory is nothing but theory of valence electron moving in a periodic potential field of crystalline lattice. Since atoms have high discrete energy spectrum, which means they can occupy only discrete energy levels, part of this energy level are filled with electrons in a non-excited condition. The energy band diagram of a semiconductor where the conduction band is empty and the valence band is completely filled in conductor. As we have discussed in our previous session itself, you can see the energy band of three types of materials like conductors, insulators and semiconductors. Conductors is fully, conduction band is completely filled, whereas in semiconductors, partial filled of conductors and the valence band, whereas in insulator, valence band is completely filled, which results in no conduction at all. And so this energy band diagram is used to find the conduction and valence band filled levels and their conductivity values. As you can see here, this energy band EG above is the conduction EC, below is the valence band EV, and middle lies the conduction for forward condition in a PN junction diode. So this is the conductivity diagram, and you can find the value of conductivity value for intrinsic semiconductor Ni is equal to Nc into e power minus of Ec minus EFi divided by KT. For N-type and P-type, we can separately draw this diagram, as we can see in this diagrammatic representation, valence band and conduction band, how it lies for N-type. Donor atoms are more here, and for P-type, acceptor ions are more. And so ED lies closer to the conduction band and EA lies closer to the valence band in P-type semiconductors. Moving to the value of potential VBI, higher level both energy band gap of E1 and E2, which is obtained from this gap, energy gap from the diagram, modulus of E1 plus modulus of E2, where E1 is equal to EFi minus EFP and E2 is equal to EFN minus EFI. So this F represents the intrinsic semiconductor Fermi level of intrinsic semiconductor EFI. And also moving to the values of N0, it is obtained from the conduction and Fermi level Nc into exponential of minus of Ec minus EF divided by KT, where K and T are the constants which we can obtain from the equations. V2 is equal to minus KT divided by Q ln of ND divided by Ni, and correspondingly for P-type, P0 is equal to same equation, NV exponential of minus EC minus EF divided by KT. So here, it is corresponding to the valence band, we do the calculation, and V1 is equal to KT by Q into ln of NA divided by NI. NA is the acceptor ions, and there for donor ions is the majority carriers. So finding the value of total value of VBI from the equations of V1 and V2, we are finding the equation as KT divided by Q ln of NAND divided by NI square. So probably they will be asking the problem using this equation. And you can see this entire diagram of energy band diagram of forward bias condition of PN junction diode. And reverse bias condition also you can see here. So in reverse bias condition, there will be no conduction of current. And so the E field is very, very minimum, as you can see in this diagram. So moving to the problem based on this current flow, you can see here, when a reverse bias is applied to a PN junction diode of germanium type, the reverse saturation current at room temperature is 0.3 microamps. Determine the current flowing in diode when 0.15 volt forward bias is applied at room temperature. So they have given the value of I0, reverse saturation current, VF, voltage applied. So I is equal to I0 into e power, we know at room temperature the value is 40 V divided by eta in minus 1. So I am substituting the value of I naught directly and finding the value of V also. I know the value, so I am substituting the value of V also. So simplifying, I will be getting the value Y is equal to 0.120 milliamps. Another problem, the reverse saturation current of a silicon PN junction diode is 10 microamps. Calculate the diode current for the forward bias voltage of 0.6 volt at 25 degrees Celsius. So I know VT is equal to T by 11600, where the temperature here is 273 Kelvin. So 273 plus 25 divided by 11600, I can find the value of VT from here, and from this I can find the value of I by using this equation. So I here obtained as 1.174 amps. So this is about the energy band diagram, drift, diffusion, current densities. Talking about the practical applications, as we have seen in our earlier classes, so our LEDs, switches, and especially limiters, clippers, clampers, and comes under this PN junction diode. So we need to find the value of the energy band occupied, then only we can clearly designate the values of Fermi level values, valence band, conduction band, occupied levels. So we need to find each and every value of the diodes, then only we can apply in any real-time application as per our need. So this is about the drift and diffusion current densities. If you have any doubts in this, you can ask me and get the details. Thank you.